Hi friends, welcome to Happy Kids India. Thanks for joining the Python training with me. In this session, we are going to learn file operations or file management with Python. I'm opening a Python file, notepadf.py. So py should be the extension for all Python files, source code files. F is the file name here. Enter. Okay. Here, I'm opening a file f equal to open. In this function, there will be two arguments. First argument is the file name. Let me say some a.txt. We can give the file name directly. That means it will create in the current directory. Here current directory is users/Krishna. Otherwise, we can also give the full path. For example, c:\users/krishna/a.txt. We can also give like this. Here I am giving the file name directly, and in the second argument, if we do not give anything, it will consider as rt. That means read, we are opening the file in read mode. For that purpose, the file should be existing already, and t means text file. It is a text file, not a binary file. The second option can be B, that means binary file. So we generally do not work with binary files. So let us open in text mode. And here either read, R is for read, W is for write, X is for create, and A is for append. Read means the file should be already there so that we can perform read operations. Write means if the file already exists, it will overwrite the content. It will remove the existing content and write. If the file does not exist, it will create a new file. X means just create a new file. If the file already exists, it will give an error. So let us see one by one. Here I am trying to give XT. X means create a file. It's a text file. F means we are assigning the handle of the file to F so that we can perform file operations. For example, I'm trying to do file read. So let us say A equal to file read and print A. Let us execute it here. Python f.py. This is the syntax for executing. So this gives an error. It says not readable, because we did not give the read mode. We gave X means create mode. Let us see whether the file got created. Directory a.txt, right? We gave a.txt. See, the file got created with 0 bytes. We did not write any content to that. It got created. And let us try to execute again. Here another error. It says file exists. It is already there. First time the file was not there, it created the file, but while reading it gave an error. But the second time it says file already exists, because X means create a file if the file does not exist already, otherwise it gives an error. So instead of this, let us give R. In this case, we are opening the file in read mode, then we are reading the content of this file and storing in A and printing the content, but this file does not have any content, right? So let us execute this one. Let me clear the screen. See, this file does not have any content. There are no errors, but there is no content in this file. Which file? A.txt. There is no content, so it is not printing anything. So let us write some content in this file. For example, notepad a.txt. Let me say Krishna, male, 45, YJOG, engineer. Let us also put a few more lines. Satvi, male, 11, Bangalore, student. John, male, 35. Let us put comma. So we can give any format, not only comma separated. Let's say Mumbai. And doctor. Let's say Salim, male 40 own a advocate, something like that. I'm saving it. So this file has the content. You can see this file has the content. And now let us execute this Python program, Python f.py. So you can see it is reading the entire content of this file, placing it in A, and it's printing. This is nothing but a string. Let us print the type of this also. Type of print, type of A. So we can see A is of string type. So you can see class string. Now instead of reading the entire file, we can also read, for example, I'm saying 5. 5 means the first 5 characters in this file. So let us execute and see. So you can see only the first 5 letters got printed. It read only first 5 characters in the file and it printed. It also printed the type, of course. Let us remove this. We can also print directly like this, print. Print. Here instead of this one, let us say read line. Read lines means one line, the first line will be read, and I'm also printing it directly. So let us execute and see. The first line got read and printed. And we can also execute this one 4 times because there are 4 lines. Let us execute and see. So you can see all the 4 lines got printed. Also you can see one line in between each line. This is because print prints an additional new line. So for example, I can say end equal to nothing, then it will not print the additional new line because new line is already there in the text file. So each line we entered, right? So let's say, so you can see all the 4 lines got printed. Instead of this, we can also use for loop. For example, for line in f colon, so I'm removing all this and I'm only keeping one line and giving the indentation. So this can be any variable name for line in f, and here we just have to give line. If I give l here, you can give l, any name, any variable name here. F is the file handle. It will print one by one line. So let us execute and see. So you can see it is printing all the 4 lines. For example, let us say in this file there are no commas. For example, I'm removing these commas in the text file. I'm removing the commas and let us execute again. It is just reading line by line and printing. Now I want to print with commas. This text file does not have commas, but I want to print it with commas. In that case, what we should do here, for example, let us take a list. Let us say list equal to line dot split. This line is one line in the file, right? So I'm splitting into different words and taking into list, and let us print a list. And let us execute and see. See, this is printing the list. Each line got converted to a list and printing it like this. But we don't want in this format. So this is putting quotes and all that, single quotes. We want to print word by word. Here I'm using one more for loop for let us say word, for word in list. From this list, let us take each word. Here also you can use any variable name. You can use W or anything. And here I am printing word. So this loop skips through each line in this text file, and this loop skips through each word in the list. This list has each line, right? For each line, we are separating into each word. So by default, this will print each word in one line. So let us execute and see. So you can see each word is printed in each line. Instead of that, we want to print end equal to comma. You can also print space. So let us see. So it is printing like this: Krishna comma space then val comma space like this. And of course after each line we need a new line. So that means, so after printing the each line, we are printing a new line. In this file, each word is separated with spaces. We are printing with comma separated values. So what we have seen? We have seen X for creating a file, R for reading a file. Now instead of printing it to the screen, let us try to write it into a new file. Here I am opening one more file, for example, F2 is equal to open, let us say some a.out, any file name, I am taking a.out and I am saying write in text mode. So here instead of printing it, so I want to write it to which one? F2 write. Here I cannot use this end, this is used in, end is used in print statement, but here it takes only one string. So I am just concatenating. So write the word plus comma for each word, write it to a file. So let us see. So this file does not exist, right? A.out does not exist. Let us see directory a.out. This file does not exist, file not found. So it will create when the file is not there, does not exist. W means it will create a file and it will write it. So we are reading from a.txt and writing into a.out with commas. Let us see, a.txt does not have commas, but a.out we are writing with commas. Let us execute and see. So python f.py, this got executed. Now type a.out. See, this file got written, it got created and it wrote to the this file also. It read from a.txt and wrote to a.out. Here we gave print, so it is just printing the spaces. So instead of that, this also we have to write to that file, right? So F2 write, here we have to give new line means slash n. So let us execute again. So this time it wrote new line also after each line, but the old content got overwritten, right? This content is no more in the a.out, because W, if the file does not exist, it will create a file and write, and if the file exists, it will overwrite the content. The old content will get overwritten with the new content. So instead of that, this time let us say, I'm saying a append mode. Let us see, I'm executing again. This time if you see the content, there are 8 lines, because first time it wrote 4 lines, next time it appended 4 more lines. Let me execute again. So you can see this time it has 12 lines, 4 lines, 4 lines, 4 lines. 3 times we executed, 3 times it appended the content. So append mode means it will overwrite it. So here instead of reading from this file, so let us input from the keyboard. Let us take while loop here. While true means always true, and list equal to input split. List equal to input then split, and while true means it keeps on asking. So it keeps on asking, and then in for each word in list, it will write to this file. It will write the word and then adds a comma, and after the line it writes a new line. But this loop will go on forever. So instead of that, let us say a equal to 0 and a equal to a plus 1. So each time we input, we are incrementing this a value. And let us say if a greater than 3, break. That means only 3 times it will be read. 4th time, whatever we input, it will not consider, it will simply break it. So let us do that. Otherwise, we can also use for loop, for I in range 3, something like that. So why I am saying this, I will show you. So I am executing it. Python f.py yeah, this column added. So it is waiting for the input. So I'm giving whatever we want, you can give Krishna, male, 35, engineer, Prashant, male, 40, doctor, wise job, whatever we give, it simply takes. Mohan, male, 30, advocate, Bangalore, three lines, and next time I'm writing something and entering, so it will not write. So let us see, type a dot hop. See, these three lines it wrote because it appended. It appended because we use the append function. Otherwise, if you use W, it will overwrite. So let us do again. Let's do again. Mohan, engineer, Bangalore. Krishna, Dr. Vizag, John, advocate, New York. See, fourth time, whatever we enter, it will not take. And now let us see, type a dot op. Only three lines will be there. The existing content was overwritten. Instead of this count, let us say I'm removing this count now, and so we can also say like this. Suppose list means multiple elements, right? So whatever row we enter in the line, it will convert to multiple words, it will store in the list. So let us compare the first word, that is list of zero. If list of zero equal to by, or list of zero equal to done, or list of zero equal to exit break. So otherwise it will write to the file. So now this time it is not three times. Let us see, end of line while scanning string letter. Okay, I did not close it properly. Save, and here this time I'm executing. This time I'm saying Mohan, engineer, Bangalore, and the second line itself I'm saying by. So it will exit. You can see type a dot out. So you can print any number of lines. So let me say again, execute Mohan, Dr. Vizag, Sattvic, student, Bangalore, Salim, advocate, Mumbai, and this time I'm saying exit, type a dot out. So it is printing three lines. I already gave comma, and while writing I'm adding another comma. So it is doing like this. It has overwritten the whole content. So now let us not type comma. Mohan, Bangalore, engineer, Krishna, Vizag, doctor, Sattvic, advocate, Chennai, something, and exit. And let us see, type a dot out. So this time we did not give any commas, but it added commas and returned to the a dot out. So we have seen the difference, right? If I put append mode, it will append at the end of the file. That means existing content also will be retained. But if you use W, existing content will be overwritten. R means reading an existing file. X means creating a new file. This time let us read this file, a.txt, and let us say for line in F2, list equal to line dot split, and for word in line print word. Let us print word by word. So we are reading from this file, we are opening in read mode, and I am reading it line by line, and I am splitting it two words, and I am printing each word by word. Let us see. So it is printing word by word, right? So what if the name is, for example, two words, Krishna Mohan, or city is New York? It's possible that it may have multiple words, right? So for that reason, we have to use the comma separated values. Krishna Mohan, this time I'm giving two words in the name. So let us give engineer, and Satvik is only one word, for example, Bangalore, and John Mail 35. But here I'm giving two words, New York, Dr. Salim Mail 40, Pune. Let us give two words here. Okay, software engineer. In that case, what it will print? So let us execute and see. So here it is separating word by word. Krishna separate, Mohan separate, like that. But we don't want like that. We want Krishna Mohan to be together. So in that case, what we have to give? In the split command, we can give comma. Then it will separate based on the comma. So let us see. So you can see software engineer came in one single word. Krishna Mohan came in one single word. New York came in one single word. This is because we are splitting based on comma. Of course, after comma, there are spaces sometimes. So that is the reason it is taking spaces. That if you want, we can strip it. We know, right? Here I can say word dot strip. Let us execute again. So the additional space got stripped. Also, while printing, if you want a comma, we can add a comma. Execute and see. See, this time it is adding comma. And also in the print, we can take end equal to null instead of new line, right? So you can see it's not printed as each word in different line, but we want a new line after each line. So let us print one blank line. This loop will print one line, all the words in one line. So after one line, we are printing a new line. So you can print like this. You can also write to a different file. We have already seen this. So this is about file management. Also, one more thing, we also have to close the file. F dot, here F2, right? F2 dot close. Whenever we open a file, so once the operations are over with that file, we have to close it. So I am closing it outside this loop. So this is not required. So there is no difference here, but we have to close it. Similarly, we can also delete the file. For that, we have to import OS, and we can remove a file like OS dot remove, and we can give the complete path or the file in the current folder or current directory. So I'm saying, for example, I want to delete this a dot out. First, let us see a dot out whether it exists or not. It is there. Now let us execute this file. Now let us see a dot out. So the file is no more, it got removed. So this is a dangerous function. Don't use it unless you are very sure about it. So this will remove the file. We can also give path like this: c:\users/krishna/a.out. Full path also you can give, or you can also give the file name. So we have also seen reading a file. We are creating a new file with the X, reading a file and writing a file and appending a file and text file. We have seen the text file, and also we have seen F2 dot read. That means it reads the entire file. Read line means it reads one single line. Though this split we have already seen. Split means it will split the string into a list, means each word will be separated as a separate element and it will store it in a list. we have also seen f2 dot write. Write means whatever string we give, it will take. We can also use concatenation, right, like this, but this is considered a single string. It takes single string. So we have also seen open and close, and we can also delete the file using os.remove the file name. For this we have to import the library or module, Python module called os, import os. So this is about file management. In the coming sessions we will learn more about file management, like there is a separate module for CSV, comma separated files. So we have seen comma separated files. For example, this is a comma separated file. So what is the advantage of this comma separated file is this file can be directly opened in Excel, MS Excel. Also MS Excel file can be converted to a CSV, comma separated file, like this, and we can write a Python program to read the data. For example, this has mocks. For example, we can read these mocks and we can calculate the grade, GPA, etc., the result, pass, fail, which grade and all that, and we can write it into a separate file. For example, so we can take the data from Excel sheet or from any database, like Oracle, MySQL, any database. That file can be converted to a comma separated file like this, CSV files, and we can use Python to manage those files. And there is a separate library called CSV, import CSV, and there are functions available in this CSV file to manage CSV files. CSV means comma separated files. So we will learn all those things in the next sessions. Before that we have to learn tuple, dictionary, etc. So we will learn all those aspects in the coming sessions. Thank you so much. If you are new to this channel or if you have not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe and do not forget to press the bell icon so that you will get notification. Thank you so much.